Hey guys, welcome back to World of Tanks. My name is Bruce and today we take a look at some of the French autoloader in World of Tanks. I will share 10 golden tips for you in order to improve your autoloader gameplay. So if you're still trying to master this special class of tanks, then this video will definitely help you out. And as always, if you're interested in more reviews and gameplay, go to YouTube and search for World of Tanks with Bruce to get all of my videos. Or click on the subscribe button and now let's go. Here we are in the first game. We are on Pokrovka with the Badger 25T. And if we take a look at the weaponry of this tank, it has a quite good DPM. It has a 5-shot autoloader clip with 390 alpha damage, so you can deal up to 1950 average damage with only one clip. But this is where the good news ends, because the gun is not the most accurate, dispersion 0.36, the aim time is pretty long with 2.59 seconds, and the intra clip reload takes 2.73 seconds. So all in all, the reload time is pretty long with stock almost 40 seconds, and also the gun handling is not the greatest. Alright, let's now concentrate on the game, and this is where I have the first tip for you for your auto loader gameplay. Don't limit yourself on the firepower of your tank. Autoloaders have unique firepower, yes, but if the situation demands spotting, then spot for your team. And especially in a tank like the Badger 25T, this is another possibility that you have and that you can do. And as you can see, we are going into this bush here because we want to spot the enemy tanks that are approaching the hill on the zero lane. And that is exactly what we want to do. Now, we were lucky because we got 2 shots on the M46 Patton, but now we want to concentrate and spot the hill, and we can even shoot on them and use the double bush in order to not get spotted. Alright, perfect. So, alright. Yeah, so a perfect start for us. 1600 damage so far. We made 4 shots and now I want to go into the reload. Now we can spot the rest of the enemy team on the hill and look at the sweet spotting damage that we can collect. Super nice. And we will just sit here and wait until the enemies are finished off, and we just want to collect the spotting damage. Perfect. So, a couple more seconds, then we will have reloaded our second clip. Let's see if we can keep spotting enemy tanks on the zero lane. Here we go. Let's get a shot on the TVP. Nice. And a second shot. Superb. Nice. As you can see, we already collected 2300 damage and made 1000 spotting damage. Super nice start in this game. Alright, now we get spotted. Most likely due to the medium tanks in the middle, the AE phase 1. And here's where I have the second tip for you. Always have an exit option in your autoloader. After your clip, you are vulnerable and unable to defend yourself, so never go to a strategic position on your own if you cannot exit this position after you have emptied your clip or after you got spotted. And I just want to wait behind this building here so that I am not spotted anymore, and then, as you can see, I will just evade into the middle and then from this position, because now the enemy knows that I am here. I mean, the medium tanks already knew that I was here because of my damage. But in this position, I can just evade through the middle where the E50M is, and then just leave this position and then just assess the situation and think of another approach in order to pressure the enemy. All right, so looks like the enemy is not concentrating on me again. Also looks like the T-30 is just falling back, so I will use this moment in order to evade. Not too bad, I crashed my tracks here. That was a little mistake from my side, but no problem at all. And I immediately want to go into the reload, because I always want to start the reload when I am relocating on the map and when I am not trying to make pressure, so that once I arrive at the important position, my clip is already reloaded. Now, there are two options that I could have now in this situation. I could support the one or two lane with trying to spot there and helping the ECMV5, the EML2 and the two tank destroyers. But I want to go to the zero lane again because there are two heavy tanks there, the Object 275 and the IS. But the problem for them is that they don't have the first spot advantage due to the fact that the enemy does have medium tanks on the zero lane, so I want to use my camo rating and my spotting abilities to help them out and to use their firepower or to integrate their firepower into the team. Right, let's see, looks like the Object 257 is advancing. I don't know if this is the best idea. Right, and this is where I have the next tip for you. The third tip is use your autoloader as a one-shot tank, if it is feasible, to avoid taking damage. In an autoloader, one of the most important things you have to keep in mind is you can play your tank like an autoloader and you can empty your clip like as soon as possible, but you don't have to do this. You can play your autoloader tank like a regular one-shot tank to avoid damage. That is super, super important. And as always, you should try to preserve your hit points until the end of the game. Alright, so this is what we did here with our two shots. We made one shot, but that is fine. And let's see if we can get a shot on the enemy medium tank. Maybe on the T-30 if he keeps advancing. Let's see. There you go. Another nice shot. Alright, okay, so he's finished off. I need to go into the reload, okay, and looks like my two heavy tanks on my lane are advancing, but I need to make sure that the enemy is not spotting me or not concentrating on me, and I need to reload my clip. Alright, but as they are advancing, I definitely want to help them out, and I know that there is another medium tank somewhere here. There you go, the 1-2-1, and I just want to approach so that my clip is reloaded once I am, let's see, can I get a shot, once I am close to them. And as you can see, this is the next tip I have for you, and that is learn how to use auto-aim in conjunction with the Circle of Death. With this technique, you will be able to evade enemy shots while being able to empty your full clip. And as you can see, I could concentrate on driving around the tank and thus evading shots. And on the other hand, this is the only situation in which I want to use auto-aim, because auto-aim always aims at the center of the enemy tank, and the center of the enemy tank can be the spot where the enemy does have a good armor protection, so you will not penetrate your shots. But if you have to concentrate fully on your driving skills in order to evade enemy shots, then this is what you should do, and in an autoloader this can be extremely important and can give you the opportunity to empty your full clip without taking shots. Alright, so can we get a shot on the... No, he's already finished. Very nice. So the game is already won, and now we want to collect further damage. Right, looks like the tank destroyer is already killed. Okay, we are spotted, so let's fall down into this ditch so we cannot get any shots. There are only three tanks remaining, so we need to make sure to get some additional damage. So far we made 6,000 damage combined. Super nice game. And this is where I have the fifth tip for you, and that is stay alive until the end game. Autoloaders are extremely dangerous at the end of the game, where they can clip out tanks that have lost only some hit points. Here we go. Get some damage, kill it, and can we get some? No, we can't. Okay, so this was a bad example for the last tip. However, that is extremely important in an autoloader. You want to stay alive until the end game, because in the end, it is super easy for you to collect 1,000, 2,000 damage just because you are an autoloader. Alright, here we are in the second game, and this time we are playing with the MX 5100, And I selected this replay in order to show you some autoloader gameplay with an autoloader heavy tank. Because you might argue, well, the Badgehead does have some unique spotting capabilities, but what about those tanks that do not have this possibility? And the AMX 5100 is such a tank. It is a very sluggish heavy tank. And if we take a look at the weaponry, the DPM is mediocre. It does have a wonderful 6-shot clip, and it can deal up to 1100 damage with one clip. However, the reload time is tremendously high with 48.61 seconds stock. The penetration is nice. The intra-clip reload is pretty long with 2.73 seconds, and the aim time is also pretty long. The dispersion is pretty mediocre, 0.35, so yeah, we have a heavy tank with a super nice 6-shot clip, but with mediocre gun handling and being unable to spot enemy tanks because it is a heavy tank. Alright, so I like to go to this position on Overlord because I want to surprise the enemy tanks that are approaching, like the Narvan Action 10. And alright, we bounce the first shot. And let's see if we can get some other shot. And this is another example where you have to play an autoloader as a one-shot tank, because I cannot stand out in the open and make any damage without preserving my hit points. And so I do need to play this tank like a one-shot tank in this situation. Okay, so we managed to make one shot, which is nice. And now let's see. I want to move a little bit forward, so if he falls back, then I might get another shot onto him. So let's see. Maybe. I think it's time to be patient. Alright, so he's finished off. Nice. And let's see. Alright, so let's take a look at the minimap and assess the situation. And here you go. Yeah, now you can look at take a look at the minimap and see what you would do in this situation. In this situation, I want to punish the AE phase 1, because in an autoloader I'm always looking for a tank that has isolated himself so that I can clip him out. Alright, so I was lucky in this situation and did not take any damage. However, this brings me to the 6th tip that I have for you. Only empty your clip if you can avoid taking damage, or if you are willing to take that damage. And in this situation I was definitely willing to take that damage, because I could take out a tier 9 tank, which is very, very, very dangerous in this game. And if I get the chance to take out a tier 9 tank with my tier 8 tank, then I'm always happy to do so. Alright, now, what can we do? We want to relocate, and we want to use the time that it takes to reload our clip in order to relocate and to make pressure somewhere else on the battlefield. And this brings me to the 7th tip I have for you. Always try to surprise your enemies. Don't work on the same position throughout the game. If you manage to surprise your opponents, you will have a better chance to empty all of your clip rather than only one or two shots. And this is what we wanted to do here. Unfortunately, we got a shot from the Leopard PTA and also the ELC even, waiting in the back. Too bad, but at least we could make two shots. And let's try and relocate once again. And let's try to maybe clip out the Tiger 2. Hopefully he is looking towards the other tanks. No, he's moving to me. Alright, so let's concentrate on the other dangerous tanks here. Yeah, and I should have expected this. The Tiger 2 was moving towards me, but now he is finally turning his turret away, so maybe we can get some more shots. And yeah, as you can see, I get some shots by the... Yeah, alright. So I get killed by the P-44 Pantera, which is fine. All in all, I was able to help my team to finish off the Tiger 2, and thus offering the heavy tanks, as you could see in the middle of the map, to advance further. And in the end, we will win the game because we do have map control. And I think this was a nice example on how to play autoloader heavy tanks. And I think 3300 damage with the AMX 5100 is pretty nice. So let's jump into the next game. Alright, game number 3, and this time we are playing with the AMX 50B, another, I would say, difficult to play autoloader tank. The AMX 50B is the tier 10 French heavy tank. It offers a pretty nice DPM for an autoloader tank, 2600. The alpha damage is also pretty nice. It has a 4-shot autoloader clip, so you can deal 1600 damage within 7.5 seconds, and the reload time is approximately 29 seconds stock. So the advantage of this tank is that the gun handling is pretty nice. Dispersion 0.34, intra-clip reload is also okay with 2.5 seconds, and the aim time is 2.4 seconds, which is also pretty okay. So compared to the AMX 5100, this tank basically plays the same. The advantage of this tank is that it does have a good hull armor, at least in the front. The armor in the turret is trash, just like on the AMX 5100, but the gun handling is much better, and also you are more flexible because you have only a 4-shot autoloader clip and not a 6-shot clip like on the AMX 5100. Alright, so we want to use our speed that we have in order to get into a nice position, and I want to knock down this wall here so I can spot the enemy tanks if they are crossing on the K lane and moving towards the K0 position. So we will just wait here and try to surprise enemy tanks if they are doing a mistake. Meanwhile, hopefully the rest of our team, like the Conqueror and the Tank Destroyers, will finally also make their way into the village, the little city here. And in an autoloader, what you want to do is you want to surprise your enemies. And patience is the key to success. Here you go. So we want to punish the AE phase 1, and we always want to go for a track shot. This is super, super important. In an autoloader tank. Alright, so nice. We could make 3 shots out of our 4-shot clip. Super, super nice. And now we want to reload. And this is where I have the 8th tip for you. Learn how to conduct second line gameplay. Use other tanks, for example heavies, like this E100, to bait a shot. Thereafter, during the reload time of the enemy tank, you can move out of cover and start emptying your clip. And this is especially important, and with this tip, you will be able to fight in a village and brawl with other heavy tanks. But you need another, like a heavy tank that baits the shots for you, so that you can, once he has taken a shot from the enemy, then move out of cover and empty your clip. So let's see if we can get a track shot on the E100, and now I want to wait until he has repaired his tracks. And then, as you can see, just retrack him. This is super, super important. And in this situation, he was playing hull down, but this was the best thing I could do with my 2 shots. And now, we are basically back to our standard moves. Once we have emptied our clip, we want to relocate and we want to see where we can surprise enemies next. In an autoloader, what you want to do is you want to try to become an expert on reload times. Know your intra-clip reload, that is super important, and know the reload time of your opponent. This allows you to avoid taking damage and to assess how many shots you can take before you need to go back into cover before your opponent can shoot at you. That is super important, and this is my tip number 9 that I have for you. Alright, so our clip is reloaded, has already reloaded. The game seems to be won. Our medium tanks have won the flank, and now I want to punish the E100. A little hole here. Let's see. I'm pretty much willing to take a shot because I have reserved my hit points pretty good. Okay. He gets a shot on us, but that is fine. And now, as I said, I know the reload time of the E100, and we can even finish off the CS59. At least it looked like it, but as you can see on the stats, we didn't actually finish him off. Alright, as you can see, I knew the reload time of the E100. I took one shot, that was intentionally, and then I could finish him off with my clip. That is super nice. And now, I want to reload my clip and then approach the E100. And he is fortunately turning towards the other tank. Super nice. And now we can just clip him out. Look at that. Second. And we can finish him off. Super, super nice. And I immediately go into the reload. And let's see if we can get some more damage. So the game is 5 minutes old. And we made 3,200 damage. 600 spotting. So 3,800 damage combined within 5 minutes, which is, in my opinion, a pretty nice result in this game. Okay, so there's only one tank destroyer remaining. Let's see if we can get another shot. And obviously, the advantage of the AMX 50B is its mobility. Too bad. Right. So the gun is trolling us here, so we don't get another shot, which is fine. But once again, 3,800 combined within 5 minutes of the game is a nice result. And let's now start with the last game. Okay, perfect. Last game for us. This time we play the Scharf Future 4. And this is a very special tank, a tier 9 French Revolt tank. And as you can see, this tank has a super, super long reload time of its clip, almost 40 seconds. And also the intra clip reload is super, super long with 4 seconds. Now, it does have its advantage, just like the Badger 25T. It's perfectly fine for spotting and also for taking over the role of a light tank. And also the gun handling is pretty nice. As you can see, 0.33 dispersion, 2.11 aim time is super nice, and does have a nice penetration of 264 with its alpha damage of 390. So yeah, this is pretty nice, but as you can see, the reload time of the clip is super, super long, and also the intro clip reload means that it takes you 12 seconds to empty your clip. So yeah, extremely difficult to play, but this is why I made this video, in order to help you out. Alright, so in this game, we are top tier, as you can see, and we want to use that momentum and go into the important position. And as in so many videos on this map, it is the south. And first of all, I want to come to a standstill in this bush and see whether the enemy tanks are advancing. Doesn't look like, so I think it's time, together with the help of the Panther, to move forward and to secure this position. And let's see if we can spot some other tanks. Okay, it doesn't look like. Looks like there's no tank. And so, being top tier, I want to make pressure and I don't want to lose time. And so, here we go. Maybe we can get a cross shot. Here we go, maybe on the convoy. Nice. Okay, looks like he's hiding behind the building there. I'm not sure if this one actually hit. I don't know where this shot went. Okay, so let's go into the super important position, and that is the E7 position. And this is where I have the last tip for you, the last golden tip, and that is use your clip reload to assess the minimap and to relocate in order to surprise your enemies. With your autoloader, you can time your clip reload so that you always arrive with a full clip and the maximum firepower before you start the next engagement. But you always want to use the reload time in order to relocate on the map. So if you have emptied your clip, assess the minimap, see where you can go next and where you can surprise the enemies. And as you can see now, our clip has reloaded. And let's see if we can spot somebody. And get some shots. All right, maybe on the Super Hellcat. Let's see. Aim time now is already finished off, which is nice. Looks like, yeah, looks like the enemy team has a weird setup. All the enemy tanks are located in the north. Okay, maybe on this tank. Let's see. No, the first one doesn't go in. Okay, he shot, so I can take my second shot. Here you go. But now I do need to fall back because of the convoy. Alright, and even the Progetto gets one shot on me, but because I had fallen back so early, he only could manage to get one single shot on me. Alright, so let's peek out here. Once again, maybe we can get a shot on the convoy. Look like... OK, Okay. Does it look like maybe no? The enemy LP-432 is also behind cover. So I will go into the reload and let's see what I can do. Looks like the Brusque is playing aggressively. How, yeah, that was a little bit too aggressively. He gets killed by the MX-65T. So maybe we can keep spotting enemies right here. And the problem is, like, I would advance to the D6 position. However, I do need to play it cautiously, because in this position I can be under crossfire from the C2 position where the tortoise is. Let's see, maybe we can get a shot on the Rusk. Looks like, I think he's behind a building. Looks like the Rusk player knows what he's doing. Okay, so far, at least we get some nice spotting damage. Maybe we can get a shot on the KV-3. No? But so far, so good. As I said, in an autoloader, patience, and in general, in every tank, patience is the key to success, but especially in an autoloader. Time will come and your opportunity to empty your clip will come. Just be patient and just stay alive until the endgame and don't throw away your tank too early in the game. That is super, super important. Alright, so let's proceed a little bit more to the left of the map. And here you go. There's the... I'm spotted, so I definitely do not want to stand here, keep standing here, but maybe I can get a shot on the tortoise. Nice. He's not even turning around, so we can finish him off. Yep, super nice. Here you go. Alright, and I go into the reload, because I think the next 10 seconds I will not get the possibility to get a shot on an enemy tank, so I rather want to go into the reload and then have a full clip once the opportunities arise. Okay, so looks like our team is proceeding on the zero lane, which is nice, and I think now the time has come to move out a little bit and to try to spot some of the opponents. I need to play cautiously due to the convoy which is behind this building, and I definitely don't want to get a shot from him. But I think I should knock down this tree. The game is still pretty close. And now I can use this tree in order to spot maybe the convoy, maybe some other tanks. Okay, nice. Spot the convoy. And there's the T10, so let's finish him off. Nice. Here you go. I'm spotted, but that is not a problem at all because I am basically safe from the enemy team. Nice, and we even get spotting damage. Nice, super nice, and let's finish off the convoy. Super, super nice. Alright, so with our patience, we managed to get 1500 damage and 1000 spotting damage. And let's see if we can get a shot on the Progetto 46. No. Okay, we get a shot from the KV-3, fortunately. It doesn't make damage, but we get all the spotting damage. Super, super nice. Okay, so now... maybe we can finish him off. No, he's already finished off. Okay, so you know what? I want to go into the reload once again. Okay, that was okay. Now, in this situation, okay, I should have kept my shots because then I would have I could have taken those two shots on the IS. But yeah, hey, that's how it is. Nothing I can do. Sometimes you are just unlucky. Okay, so but my game plan is to reload the clip and then finish off the IS. It looks like he is already finished off. But if my clip is reloaded, yeah, then I can use my full clip in order to move towards the Progetto and the AMX-65T. Yeah, and once again, I'm now able to use my full clip for the next engagement, and that is what you always should try to do in your autoloader. Okay, so let's see, can we get a shot on the Progetto? Yep, he's not looking towards us. Nice, and now he has only 111 hit points remaining. I have enough hit points, so I just want to keep moving forward to the MX-65, and now I can even take a shot even from him. And I don't even want to move back into cover. I just want to finish him off. And here you go. So, we are reloading our clip. We made 5,000 damage combined. 3,000 damage, 2,000 spotting, super nice game. And as you can see, in an autoloader, like it is super important to stay alive until the end game, because in the end there is just so much damage for you to make due to the fact that you are an autoloader. So in my opinion, yeah, those are the 10 golden rules. You can read them right here, and yeah, I think if you manage to fulfill those rules and if you always have those rules in mind, then you will definitely play your autoloader successful. And the benefit of an autoloader is its tremendous firepower. Sorry, it's not tremendous, it's nice firepower. And that can be such an advantage if you know how to play those tanks. Alright guys, that was it with my 10 golden tips for autoloader gameplay. As you could see, even the tough French autoloaders with their tremendous reload times will work just fine if you manage to follow those golden tips. Let me know in the comment section below whether you like to play autoloaders in World of Tanks or not. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. Consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll see you next time in another World of Tanks video.